just a slap on the wrist, a fine. That would be imprisonment along with you all. They're not going to want to take themselves along with you. They're going to try to figure out how they got this wicked, twisted information without putting themselves out. Now, that is obviously not Autumn. Where's Autumn's autopsy report, bitch? Hmm? Where is it? Where are the originals? Where's the autopsy? And who is this baby that you have been portraying as Autumn? The multi-face. The beauty marks that you put on the face that are supposed to be of epiphany. You physically injected ink into my baby's face. None of those moles were real. They've all faded away except for one that's smearing out. You fucked with the skin of my child. You are a sick bitch because you're the only one that'd be artistic enough and crazy enough to attempt to do something like that. Nobody else would have the sick balls to do it but you. That's probably why she's getting those migraine headaches. Because you're doing shit to her at night. And that scar on the side of her face. You guys are sick. So I'm thinking, you drove over, bitch.
The officers of the military.
Because she really knows what was going on. When she asked me, would you think your kid was in there all the awful kid? That right there was telling me that she didn't know. How deep this shit was that you guys were burying me in. But now that she is aware, she has the same lie as you. How the fuck can I kill my child and those injuries up to 6 days old? No more than 6 days old. How could she even be in a swing to fall off? And she couldn't even walk or hold herself up with the arms messed up the way that they were. How does any of that even fucking make sense? And during the autopsy, they can check the adrenal gland to find out if my baby was born on drugs. You guys are sick motherfucking bitches, so when it didn't work out your way, you designed an autopsy. Because somewhere down the line, somebody believed your bullshit. Marina, you didn't know me. Never have. I don't even know what your big ass looked like except for your toes are crunched up in the size. 8.5, 9 shoe and you wear a 10, 10.5. That's all I know about you. I know you had gingivitis when you was a kid. I know that you was an evil bitch all our lives, a shit starter. But we don't even know each other at all. And for you to go out of your way, to smear me because you drove over my child, I do believe. Because you wouldn't be going as deep as you are in depth. And you must have been there to get mom. And why was that car hidden in Sherry's driveway? You guys are sick. And I want you to take all these recordings. I'm going to keep calling until you do. Take them and press charges. And you got a warrant here. Go ahead. Go ahead, girl. You go ahead and do that. And Candy, I'm thinking, he all innocent? Alicia, they wouldn't go through all this to protect you. Who the fuck are you unless you was fucking Patricia? Who the fuck would you be to protect? No, Alicia, that conviction in Yamhill County. I do believe. I'm doing that.
Maximum time permitted for recording your message. If you are satisfied with your message, press 1 to listen to your message. Press 2 to send your message with normal delivery. Press 1.
County and the state, ma'am. Right here. greatest thing I've ever been seen on television. Crazier than anything I've ever seen or heard of happening. I don't even think I've seen a movie like this.
A la División de Servicios para Víctimas y Sobrevivientes de Crimen. Para español, presione el número 1. We cannot assist with immediate resources, property or vehicle damage or loss, or housing and relocation. If you are calling regarding a criminal case or conviction, contact your local DA's office. If you are calling regarding restraining or stalking orders, contact your local sexual assault or domestic violence nonprofit agency. For other resources, please call 211 or check our website at doj.state.or.us.
Okay, we're going to look at this other number she called from.
I am too, just listening to me be mad.
Carrie's slogan offer or something like that.
probably in her desk right now. Who am I speaking to?
Jamila Springer. She gave me a call a while back in regards to a Alvarez getting out of prison. I don't know who Alvarez is.
Okay, do you happen to have a case number?
Yes, I do. This is what I need to find out. Who is... It's CV02899-07, I think. I don't know.
You said...
No, that's not the case number. I don't have it on me. I don't have it on me, but... I don't know who Alvarez is. I don't know why she's calling me about some guy named Alvarez.
Yeah, and I can definitely let you know. What's your date of birth?
You guys don't even have any of my information, so that's trivial. You don't have any... Yo, listen to this. No one ever interviewed me when it came to the murder of my child. No one ever talked to me or even got any of my documentation from over in Vancouver, Washington, because that's where I lived. So you don't even know my middle name, okay? I'm just going to say this. I don't mean Leonardo Andrade Paramo. A new DOJ charge was put on him 2022. This whole case is fake. My baby was murdered and her death was mistreated. It was mishandled. And the description of the baby in the autopsy is not even Autumn. It's not even my child. The photos aren't even my baby. So I say DOJ is playing with me due to I left my girls with my uncle. I had to wean them to him because I had to do 90 days in Clark County riding with somebody on the way from the hospital. You guys have been playing with me over here in Oregon, and I really don't appreciate it. My background history is slammed, saying that I am a violent person, violent treatment against people, so Miss Triciano could get a collar. That man got a collar, and he named his firstborn son Spencer. The death certificate's fake. It's cut and paste. The death certificate has my name on it as Spencer. I've not been Spencer since I was 18 years old. Jamila Spencer is my niece. She was buried with a fake death certificate. Everything is fake. I'm so upset that I finally received the autopsy after they let it go, and that is not even my child. What is going on, DOJ? Then I get a call from some guy from Austin, some rich Austrian, saying that he used to work for DOJ, and he's got a 501(c), and he got the documentation from the Attorney General's office. Well, guess what? You guys cannot drop my stuff down from the Attorney General down to your department, because your department messed up so damn bad in 2000, so damn bad in 2002, that you guys don't really even care about the people. And I hope this conversation is being recorded, because I'm recording it on my end, because this is so foul. My baby was misrepresented, and I don't appreciate it, and you guys are going to have to do a new murder trial and find my baby's remains. Where are my baby's remains? Jamila, J-A-M-I-L-A-H. Last name, S-H-A-R-I-F as in Frank, hyphen Springer, S-P-R-I-N-G-E-R. My baby's name was Autumn, A-U-T-U-M-N, M-A-R-I-E, P-A-T-T-E-R-S-O-N. She was a year and a half when she was murdered, and that, the physical description is not Autumn. She was not 3 feet tall. She doesn't have tight pink hair. Bottom line is, that baby in that autopsy was hit by a car.
Okay, give me a second. Okay, and then, yeah, so I think you originally did give me the correct case number. I'm just going to repeat it to you. You had said CSNCAT002483CR. Okay, so go ahead and leave Carrie a message. I'll see if she's available right now, but if not,
Well, this is her only shot to talk to me, because I had to talk myself into calling her, because to me this is backwards. How is somebody gonna call me about a man I don't even know, never met before in my entire life, is doing time for murder my child? What is going on with the judicial system? I went back to school and studied criminal law just for this, and this is so foul. Okay,
all of that to you.
Huh?
She can explain any questions you have.
Okay.
Yeah. So let me put your number.
They never called me back.
Receive.
But what did you receive?
So
Is my child buried in somebody's backyard to cover up for a law enforcement officer? County. She had a car accident in Yamhill County. Matriciana come from around Yamhill County. What was he working a file and determining my freedom? They didn't even let me out to bury my baby. The whole thing is foul, and I'm so upset with... Actually, you were DOJ at that time. Okay? That crossed over from Washington County to Multnomah County with all fake documents, DOJ. How'd that happen, Austin? Mr. Austin, how does that take place? How does fake everything even get signed off? How does fake everything even get gaveled by a judge? And if I can see it's fake, all you saw was fake too. Everything's fake.
Okay.
And my baby's been dead for 22 years.
Your baby's been dead for 22 years?
She was murdered in 2000, and they just allow my stuff to be released. I had to piss a fit to even get a copy of that dang autopsy of the narrative, and the narrative doesn't even make sense. How can you blunt force trauma all over the place from Clifton Nielsen, the pathologist, but then they're gonna change it to shaken baby syndrome? My baby had ocular hemorrhaging. That means there was compression on her head that made the eyeballs bulge out. That is not shaken baby syndrome. Somebody just didn't even give a shit about my child. I'm pissed because nobody cared. And to this moment today, a whole year later, no one still gives a rat's ass, so they give it to you? Oh my God.
Okay, so what do you want me to do, Ela? Because it happened 22 years ago.
I don't want you to do anything. I just wanted to find out who you were. All right, you can't help me. Have a good day.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Okay, I need to find the one that said to come from the county and the state. This is ridiculous. They played with the wrong one. They don't care. They don't give a rat's ass about my baby, though. I'm still saying, where is my child? You guys got me fucked up and you had her last. How's that happen? Y'all had her last and I'm still asking you, where's my child?
Please hold while we find an available support agent to assist you. Your call may be recorded for monitoring purposes. If you would like to leave a voicemail, you may dial 1 at any time.
Hello, thank you for calling Info Bay. This is Cody. How can I help you?
Hi, Cody. I hope that you can. I have a question for you. I don't know if you'll be able to help me. You might need to have to transfer me. But I'm trying to find, get contact with the person to find the procedure of how the information is entered in your site and where you get it from.
Okay, ma'am, we are relying on the information made available by the county and state. And sometimes the information is missing or not available if it's not been digitized yet, because all our information comes from the county and state.
Okay, because I want to explain something to you. There's someone that's being stalked, and being stalked by a law enforcement person. And the things that they are juggling around in their background and designing, this person's in finance. But I'm trying to find out, how is this person able to do these things? Who controls the database to make sure that people aren't being abused? Hard question to answer, huh? Look, hard question to answer, huh? Oh, man. Because I'm having an issue with this, because a person, I don't know who all uses your site, but I use it just to check on things that's going on. But really, what's irritating is they're able to go back in and change and juggle. the sheriff's department that does records and things like that. You know? So you get the information from this, from who, the state?
From the state and county, ma'am.
State and county. So somebody from the state and county can come and file something and then come back later and update it and change it, huh?
Yes, ma'am, you're correct.
Okay, so I am being stalked.
Yes, ma'am, if you're being stalked, ma'am, and you you have the rights to request from your for your information to be opted out on our website, may I ask you, ma'am, under...
No. I want to be able to see this. Or I wouldn't know that they're being, that they're stalking me. You know what I'm saying?
I see, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
But anyway, no, leave me there. If I wouldn't know if you guys didn't have that on there. You know? So I appreciate you. But anyway, okay, so is there an address or a complaint department where I can... I don't want to shut you guys down and use you guys. I like being able to see what's going on in my background and stuff. But I got to make sure that that they are aware. I've filmed things and screenshots that I'm an abuse research processing center, that they are aware what some of their clients are getting away with and the things that they're entering damages people's history. Their background, give them, my baby was murdered in 2000, and the officer, the detective that handled the case, was a friend of my uncle, and he's a deputy sheriff, and I think he's covering for, I don't know really how she died, but the autopsy, the physical description is not her. Thanks for having an ear for a moment. Physical description is not her, but the injuries in there were obviously, she was hit by a car, blunt force trauma, different places from the, but anyway, I don't get it, but this person is messing with my background. He's panicking now because I went back to school to understand how cases are put together, and this person is like, I just realized he has a lot to lose. He put a man in prison and doesn't know anything, can't even speak Spanish, speak English. And I just found that he's dropping new stuff in because somebody in my computer, IP address, military IP address, confirmed by DC and crap, I'm working in the center's office. But he's still got a drug collar on the guy and continued the railroad him. And I couldn't figure out how he did besides say that this man murdered my baby with shaking baby syndrome. The whole thing is fake, you know. I can accept that. I just want to see my baby's face, pull back, whatever. But he's stalking me really close, so close that he's giving me designing RICO. I don't know if you know that is RICO Act. 3-time felons in one state. This man is making me a transporter of like 5,000 grams of fentanyl and crap like that, drug busts and possessions. And he added the same thing on this Mexican guy. Like we knew each other because he's got a lot to lose. And I didn't realize how much. I didn't realize all this was going on. But your company needs to know that there's, to be able to figure out how to monitor that, because this is like more than bullying. This is like wanting to take somebody's freedom and future away from them. And I've investigated all the way to knowing how he formed it and how he did it, because there's elements that put it together, so I knew I had to be a law enforcement. But this is so deep and so dirty that my baby was disrespected. And honestly, the way everything is fake, even the dots over any and every eye, I think she's buried in somebody's yard. I really don't think that wasn't her in the urn. That was gravel from, that was sand from the beach. You know, I went back to school and studied criminal law. This is so dirty, but now he's stalking me so damn close. But if I feel he's coming that close, I don't care who he is. I'll find him first. He had me backing out my house in Vancouver, and I didn't know what was going on. but my buddy that was with me's brother was a police officer over in Clark County. But his eyes got big, and they're saying there was a report breaking. There was like 15 cop cars out. I've never been around drugs and people busting a whole bunch of police. Now they have it like I have a violent temper. I'm a violent person, and it has this, that I've been convicted. They're juggling this stuff around in your sight, you know. But you guys need to be aware that this person is doing it, and maybe I can just turn some information from my thing over so somebody can kind of monitor it to see who's doing this shit, because they were in 2021, they came back in February 2022, and they were like fine-tuning some crap here in 2022 again and tying me and this guy that they put in prison for life. Now he's in for life. I don't know what's going on. I never met the man before in my life, you know? Nobody interviewed me, talked to me. I never got to bury my baby. It was crazy. I don't know what. But something happened. My uncle, a deputy sheriff, I don't know. But I think I want somebody to monitor my line, my input, you know? And now he's messing with the background of my daughter to get me to stop. He can't make me stop. I feel him coming, I'm going to find him first. All I can say.
Girl, you bad. I want you to be my friend. Then they shut me off. I still had 2 weeks of subscription. Like, I didn't bother. I just be moving around just to see who, what, when, where, and how.
I know, but this... Yeah, but you know what? That this is... This is tied into the FBI line. Everything that's there that's juggling around, when I check that line, the back there, is juggling around, and the local stuff is like a confirmation. I don't know. I haven't figured it out yet. But anyway, I know that you have that blurb in there that it's not to be used for credit reports or, but that stuff is real. Somebody can enter that stuff. That stuff is real, and it interferes with a person's background. I wish you had an email to send you what they were doing. But anyway, thanks for listening.
Yes, ma'am. You can send
Me
email to our office at support@infobay.com regarding your concern. Thank you for bringing this up to us.
Okay, what's the call it? Wait, hold on. You said email who?
Our back office, ma'am, regarding your concern.
What's their email?
Support@infobay.com.
Support@infobay.com. Can you spell it for me?
Why?
Can you spell it for me?
Yes, ma'am. It's support, S-U-B, as in Peter, B as in Peter, O as in Oscar, R.
I'm
have to play this. This one was played earlier. I have to let you hear this one while this part of the thing is playing. Take it away. I'm gonna say, go on with your investigation. That should be right there. It's changed. She said, go on with your investigation. Ain't nobody gonna be implicated, not from my house. Sister, I'm not my mother. I'll let you hear the whole thing. The girl's sick. My whole family, I don't understand. They are whacked. Kill my baby. I wasn't supposed to find out this.
This is your Aunt Rita. You knew you were only
this is her right here.
A tool, a weapon, when you provoked your mother to come after me. This is a pattern of behavior that you obviously have. And I think it's sick. I think you're as sick as your mother. You're going to end up losing your child because you know what, Tiffany? I'm not the one. I'm not my sister who can't rationalize. I'm not my mother. I am not these people. I see what you're doing, and it is self-destruction because I can blink and not look at you again. But what really concerns me most is your mother's pattern of your behavior and your mother's pattern of behavior is nothing new. It is obvious to me.
I don't even know the bitch.
You use your mother as a weapon. When you want to go after someone, you just give your mother a little bit of filter so that she goes in on them. That makes you very, you know, Sherry mentioned demons. I feel sorry for you, Epiphany, because no one's telling you right.
Okay, I can't do this. I do this all the time. I can't do this. I'm finna do this. Fuck that bitch. I'm done. When I listen to this, it gives me a headache. You know why? I don't even know this bitch. I don't even know these people. I didn't even talk growing up. I peed to bed till I was 12 because they fought all the damn time. I was an introvert. This is sick. I'm gonna call the bitch. I gotta call the bitch. Right the fuck now. I'm gonna need people. She made the same fucking threat. And I lost a baby. I said, Rita, you don't even know me. Oh, that's not it right there. 503. I must have deleted her. Crazy motherfucker. I can't stand her. There she is.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. 503-621-6011 is not available. At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
I am finalizing my research. After what you did the other day with the straitjacket, I'm explaining something to you. Sister, I don't even fucking know you. You don't even fucking know me. And I'm going to tell you one thing. All the shit you've been saying to my kids, all the shit you've been saying to my kids about me, you know good and damn well that shit's not real. I don't even fucking know. You've never been to any of my homes. You've never been into my house. All those photos that you made of my kids, those fake photos, the only way a person would commit a crime this big after committing murder is a murderer. So I'm going to say this to you. You back the fuck away from my daughter. You've been fucking with Epiphany's head. You put those dots all over her face. You back the fuck and get the fuck back to Florida before I make sure you get locked up. You talk about straitjacket, this shit that I'm looking at, you deserve one, bitch. I just had to do that shit. Fuck her. I might run my world. I've been taking care of my world myself all this time. I've never asked nobody for shit, and that bitch been running, borrowing money. I'm handing her expired pill on her workman's comp. I tracked that damn car down before I even knew all this shit was happening with the SUV. I helped the bitch track the car down after it was towed from in front of my sister's car house. This is bullshit, and you know what? I make a promise. Before I sit, and I feel you coming, any of you, I'm gonna find you fucking first.